Employers has urged the government to hold public discussions for the proposed NHIF amendment bill. According to the FKE National President Dr. Habil Olaka, the bill, if passed, would result in increased unemployment as employers who are struggling due to the impact of COVID-19 pandemic would be forced to lay off workers.
The only message I have to our two speakers, to the leadership of both the Senate and the National Assembly, there are proposals before you that will ensure that every Kenyan is able to have access to health insurance. Please expedite the passage.
A day after President Uhuru Kenyatta pushed for Parliament to pass the proposed NHIF amendment bill that will bolster the Big Four agenda of the universal health coverage, the Federation of Kenya Employers is calling upon the government to involve stakeholders in discussions.
When another burden is put on the employer to be able to finance the very well-intended program by the government, we need engagement, we need discussion and agree on what's the most effective way of pursuing with the program, because the cost cannot be fully borne by the employer.
The proposed bill, which will make it mandatory for every Kenyan above the age of 18 to contribute, also seeks to compel employers to pay contributions for their staff.
We have, over the last few years, because this is not the first time this idea has been mooted, we've presented memorandums to the relevant committee of parliament, we've engaged them, we've had retreats, and our position has been that it should be factored in that employers are already providing medical cover to their employees in the formal sector through insurances, which are in place even as we speak. We have proposed and advocated for an opt-out of NHIF as a whole for employers who have medical cover in place for the employees.
According to FKE, businesses which are already struggling due to the impact of COVID-19 will be forced to lay off workers, deepening the unemployment crisis.
The revenue inflows have since been affected by the fact that the market has been interrupted. The supply chains have been equally affected. So the ability of the employer to maintain the number of staff, given the production levels that have dwindled, is becoming a challenge.
The poor who cannot afford to contribute even the 500 shillings per month that is currently supposed to be contributed to NHIF, how do we fund that?
People in the informal sector will also not be spared.
COVID-19 did not only stop the creation of jobs in the micro enterprises, but it also wiped out 5.1 million jobs in the informal sector.
The Federation has urged the government to prioritize recovery of business, as it will go a long way in getting households and enterprises back on their feet. Margaret Wanjiru, TV 47.